Good morning, students. So in previous class, we are discussing about relations and functions and solving the problems. That topic is over. Okay. Now today I am going to deal with another topic, most important topic, easiest topic, that is mathematical induction. Mathematical induction, short for YAMA. Mathematical induction, short for is YAMA. That is mathematical induction. So in this topic, there is only one question. That is 5-mark question. Most important and easiest problem. That 5-mark question. That mathematical induction, only one problem, that problem marks is 5 mark. They will ask in final exam, in your question paper. Part D question belongs to mathematical induction, short for MI. MI means not Miss India, not Mr. India, that is mathematical induction. Okay, now here define mathematical induction. What is the meaning of mathematical induction? Now remember, mathematical induction is a process of proving the general values, general results, general values or general results or general formula. Yavudakke namu general antu karitivi 1 2 3 4 is it in general 1 antu ottava illa, simply read as 1 2 3 4 5 6 and so on. In general, N general value. In the general values anna prove madbekara, we must apply mathematical induction. So remember, it is a process of proving the general values, general results. Okay, yeah, general results as well as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. These are particular numbers. In general, we write N. Last number, in general, we say N. As you know that, in general, Nth term of arithmetic progression, we are learning 10th standard. As you know that, Nth term of arithmetic progression, denoted by Pn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. N term is general value. As you know that in trigonometry, general solution of sine theta is equal to N pi, N is general value. Then general solution of cos theta is equal to 2n pi, N is general value. These general values are not from our vector. We must apply mathematical induction. So in general, N term of AP, in general are use martini. In general, and the one simply read as first term. Here this is second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term, and so on. In general, N term of arithmetic progression, that is the formula A plus N minus 1 into D. This is general value. Similarly, in general, sum to N terms of arithmetic progression. You know, whatever it can standard. What is the formula? In general, sum to N terms of AP, N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. This is general value, general formula. This general formula na prove madbekara, we must apply mathematical induction. Similarly, in general, sum to n terms of geometric progression, gunottara sredi galu, what is the formula? A into r power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1, r power n, in general sum to n terms, these general values are not prove madbekara, we must apply mathematical induction. So the definition, it is a process of proving the general values, general results. Okay, now these are the general values. These general values are not prove madbekara, we must apply mathematical induction. Now how to prove? So to prove by mathematical induction, now here definition, remember definition of mathematical induction, it is a process of proving the, it is a process of proving the general value, general results, general values or general results. Mathematical induction is a process of general values. Yeah, generally n number of equality is general value. This is general result. This is also general value. There is some pre-terms of arithmetic progression. This is in general some pre-terms of geometric progression. These general results are not proved. We must apply mathematical induction. So definition, it is a process of proving the general values. Now how to solve? Now look here. To prove by mathematical induction, agar general values anna prove maadbekara na mathematical induction use maadkobeku. To prove by mathematical induction, short for MI, it consists of, remember, it consists of three steps. ಈ ಮೂರು ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನು ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆ ಜನರಲ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ತ್ರೀ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್? ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ನಂಬರ್ 1, ದ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಫಾರ್, ದ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಫಾರ್ n ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1. n ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಸ್ 1. ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ನಂಬರ್ 2, ಅಜ್ಯೂಮ್ ದಟ್ the result is true for n is equal to 2 ಆಗಿರಬಹುದು, or n is equal to 3 ಆಗಿರಬಹುದು, n is equal to 5, n is equal to 7, n is equal to 10, n is equal to 100. In general, n is equal to same. Just to replace n by m, or if make n is equal to k, k will use ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, or n is equal to m. This is step number. Step number 3, that is most important. The result is true for. First step n is equal to 1. Second step n is equal to m. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on in general m. Is the next step number? Next term is n is equal to m. Its next term is n is equal to m plus 1. Again, its next term is m plus 2, m plus 3, m plus 4, and so on. So there are three important steps. Remember, it consists of three steps, namely the result is true for n is equal to 1. N is equal to 1 substitute maadidaga kuda kottanta result to satisfy aagirbeku. Step number 2, assume that the result is true for n is equal to in general m, or n is equal to k. N either k substitute maadidaga kuda kottanta result to satisfy aagirbeku. And step number 3, the result is true for n is equal to next term, that is m plus 1. In all cases, the given data holds good. In all values of truth, the result satisfies our people. That is the result for mathematical induction. So remember, definition, it is a process of proving the general value or general results. Yeah, general values, these are the general values. Each general results are proved. We must apply mathematical induction. Yavaga na word general anta word use martivi, n ana term itto andre that is general value. Okay, now 2, 3, 4 in the, that is not general value. In general, now remember, in general nth term, in general last term, isn't it? So the general values anna prove maadbekara we must apply mathematical induction. How to prove? To prove by mathematical induction, it consists of three main steps. Namely, step number 1, the result is true for n is equal to 1. Step number 2, the result is true for n is equal to m. Step number 3, the result is true for n is equal to m plus 1. In all cases, the given data holds true. In all cases, now substitute maadidaga kuda kottanta result to satisfy aagirbeku. Okay? So remember the following three steps. Step number 1, the result is true for n is equal to 1. Step number 2, the result is true for n is equal to m, or n is equal to k. And step number 3, the result is true for n is equal to m plus 1. In all cases, the given data holds true. Okay, now based on the definition of mathematical induction and rule on mathematical induction to solve the problem. First problem, that is 5 mark question, problem number 1, very simple problem. So first problem says the question like this, prove by mathematical induction that 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on plus n is equal to n into n plus 1 divided by 2. That is given in the question put it down. Now what it means, sum of all terms, all terms are added by n for the n put it down, n of n plus 1 by 2. This is general value. E result and now prove by 2. E result prove by 2. We must apply 3 steps. What are the steps? Step number 1, the result is 2 for n is equal to 1. Now take one by one step. Now step number 1. First step. Step number 1. For n is equal to 1. Take n is equal to 1. This is left hand side value. Right? This is right hand side value. Now take left hand side value. LHS. In LHS, this is LHS. In LHS, the n term is here. By taking n value is 1. So LHS n value is 1. Then take RHS. What is RHS value? N of n plus 1 by 2. By taking n is equal to 1. Put n is 1. 1 into 1 plus 1 divided by 2. That is 1 plus 1, 2 divided by 2. 2 to cancel. 1. LHS 1. RHS 1. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, the result is true for the theorem, or the result is true for what? N is equal to 1. Step 1 is over. Nothing. Okay. Step number 2. Very simple. Step 2 is also very simple. In A, the result is true for n is equal to m or n is equal to k. Put n is equal to m or n is equal to k in given data. Just to replace n by m, n is the m and k. 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on plus n, n value is m is equal to, replace n by m, m into m plus 1 divided by. Step 2 is over. Okay, step 1, 1 mark. Step 2, 1 mark. Step 3, 3 mark. Totally 5 mark. Okay, then step number 3, that is most important. Step number 3. Very simple result, step 3. What is that step 3? The result is true for n is equal to m plus 1. Look here. This is last term, yeah. Its next term is, in the next term, observe it. First term is 1. Second term is 2. Third term is 3. What are they like? Fourth term is 4. Fifth term is 5. Sixth term is 6. And so on. This is m. Its next term is m plus 1. So, what can you do? Remember, adding the next term. Next term is m plus 1 term. This is m term. Its next term is m plus 1 term. Namely, adding m plus 1 term, namely, adding. How much amount do we add here? Namely, adding. Look here. In given data, in LHS of last term is n. So, we put down the problem in the left. LHS the last term is n. Anyway, n value is something more to the left. M plus 1. So, namely, adding m plus 1 on both sides. On both sides. In the step number 2. Step number 2. Where is that? Adding LHS, LHS as well as RHS, m plus 1 on both sides. See, here in LHS of last term is n. N is the name. N value is m plus 1. So, rest at 1 of m plus 1. Suppose n square is equal to rest at 1 by 2 by taking n value, m plus 1. So, here n square, that is m plus 1 whole square. Adding m plus 1 whole square. If it is n cube is there, n cube is equal to how much amount add here? N value is m plus 1 whole cube. It depends upon the given question. In the area of the LHS of last term, meaning there are n is the length, m plus 1 subsequent. Suppose if it is 2n into h by 2, 2, n value by taking m plus 1. So adding 2 times m plus 1. If this 3 n is given, adding 3 times n plus 1. Right? It depends upon the given data. So here only n term. So we are adding n plus 1 on both sides in step number 2. Step number 2. Here is 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on. Plus m. Adding m plus 1 is equal to m into m plus 1 by 2, right, as we step 2, adding m plus 1. Adding m plus 1 on both sides. LHS as well as RHS. This is as it is. This is m plus 1 add on 2. Then simplify right hand side by. Then solve on the numerical answer n of m plus 1 by 2. This is satisfied. I will check for now. So that is equal to simplify among those two. What is common term? Common is here. I think m plus 1 common, right? M plus 1 is common. Take m plus 1 common. M plus 1 common to remove to m by 2 plus 1. Because by taking m plus 1 common, right? That is equal to m plus 1 into bracket. Take the LCM. LCM is 2. 1, 2, 1, 1. 1, 2, 1, right? M into 1, M plus 1 into 2. Okay? So that is equal to M plus 1 into bracket M plus 2 by 2. M plus 2. M plus 2 can be written as plus 1 plus 1. Very well. Plus 1 plus 1 become 2. Finish. Verify, check it. The value of M plus 1. M plus 1 value, this is M, right? Into bracket, M plus 1 value, N plus 1 divided by 1, is there? N into N plus 1 divided by 2 is there? Yes, it's satisfied. Because M plus 1 value, here is N plus 1 value is N. This is N, this is also N, N into N plus 1 divided by 1, is there? Our answer will be simply common. Here, therefore, the result is true for, the result is true for n is equal to m plus 1. Hence, by mi, this mathematical induction, the result is true for all values of n. All values of n. This is the result for first problem. That is 5-mark question. Okay, I will repeat once again. Prove by mi that 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on plus n is equal to n into bracket n plus 1 divided by 2. Now, to prove by this result, by using mathematical induction, it consists of 3 steps. Maybe step number 1, the result is true for n is equal to 1. Put n is equal to 1 in given data. This is LHS part, that is RHS part. In LHS, put n is equal to 1. Last term, n value is 1. Right? Then RHS, put n is equal to 1 in RHS part, n value 1. 1 into bracket 1 plus 1 divided by 2. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 into 1, 2 divided by 2. 2, 2 cancel, that is 1. LHS 1, RHS 1. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Hence, the result is 2 for n is equal to 1. Step 1 over. Okay. Step number 2. Assume that the result is 2 for n is equal to m. Or if take n is equal to k. Either you take k or m. Just to replace n by m in given data. Put in the result n in the legal circle matrix. 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on plus m is equal to m of m plus 1 divided by 1. Step 2 is over. Step number 3, for n is equal to next term m plus 1. Adding m plus 1 term, namely adding, how much amount add here? If LHS of last term is n, by taking n values, by taking m plus 1. In last term, n is n. N is the next term to go m plus 1. That amount you have to add. Maybe adding m plus 1 on both sides in step number 2. Step 2 is the way to add money. Step 2 is 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on plus m. Adding plus m plus 1 is equal to right side as this. Adding m plus 1. Now simplify right hand side. Among those two, what is common factor? M plus 1 common. Remaining value is M by 2 plus 1. So M plus 1 into 20 take LCM. LCM is 2. 2 1s are 1 2s are M into 1 M plus 1 into 2 2. That is M plus 1 into M plus 2 by 2. To convert given data in the form of N plus 1 by 2. So how to convert it? M plus 1 written as it is. M plus 2 can be written as M plus 1 plus 1. Because 1 plus 1 is 2. Divided by 2, check it. The value of M plus 1 is by taking N. This is N. This is M plus 1, that is N. N into N plus 1 divided by 2 is there?
Yes.
Therefore, the result is true for N is equal to M plus 1. Hence, by mathematical induction, the result is true for all values of N. All values of N is N is equal to 1. N is equal to M, N is equal to M plus 1. In all cases, the given data holds good. Clear students? 5 mark question. Most important problem. Practice it. Okay. Next problem number 2. Most important 5 mark question. The question: prove by mathematical induction that 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on plus n square is equal to N into N plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6. This is general value. Left side this is number of terms. Right side it is sum of all terms, that is sum of squares of n terms of series is equal to its value is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6. Prove this result by using mathematical induction. Now to prove by mathematical induction, it consists of 3 steps. Step number 1. What is step 1? Step number 1 for n is equal to 1. Take LHS. This is LHS part. That is RHS. In LHS of class 30 n square, by taking n by 1, 1 power 2, 1 square. How much?
1.
Then take RHS. Put n is equal to 1 in RHS. N is equal to 1 into 1 plus 1 into 2n, n by 1 plus 1 divided by 6. That is 1 into 1 plus 1, 2, 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3 divided by 6, 3 2's are 6 divided by 6, 6 6 cancel, that is 1, LHS 1, RHS 1, therefore LHS is equal to RHS, therefore the result is true for the theorem is or the result is true for n is equal to 1. Step 1 over 1 mark. Step 2. Step number 2. Assume that the result is true for n is equal to m. Just to replace n by m in given data. N equal m by s. 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus and so on. N square, n by m, m square is equal to m into m plus 1. Into 2m plus 1 divided by 6. Just to replace n by m in given data. Step 2 is over. Step number 3 most important. The result is true for n is equal to m plus 1. Adding m plus 1 term. Remember, adding m plus 1 term. Namely, adding. How much amount do you have to add here? Namely, adding, just add one way to observe it. In LHS of last term n square, LHS of last term n square, n value of n square, m plus 1. Put n is equal to m plus 1. And n square, n value of m plus 1 substitute m plus 1 whole square. So, I start one way to namely adding m plus 1 whole square on both sides. In step number 2, in step 2, not step 1, in step number 2, step 2 the leg, m plus 1, whole power 2 on both sides. So we are going to read, then 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on, plus m square, right hand is step 2. In LHS, adding S number 2, M plus 1 whole power 2 is equal to M into M plus 1 into 2M plus 1 divided by 6, adding m plus 1 whole power 2. Adding m plus 1 whole square on both sides. Now simplify right hand side. If the solve model in the end of the way, it is the form of like this. N of n plus 1 into 2 n plus 1 by 6. Then it is satisfied. Okay, now check it. Is it satisfied or not? That is equal to. Among those two, simplify right hand side. Among those two, what is common factor? I think m plus 1 common is fine. So take m plus 1 common. No, m plus 1 common to take m of 2 m plus 1 divided by 6 by taking m plus 1 common. Here m plus 1 whole square. One factor m plus 1 common. One more factor is there. That is m plus 1. Right? Then simplify m plus 1 into bracket. Take the LCM. LCM is 6. Okay. Now here 1, 6, 6, 1. Remove that bracket. M into 2 m, 2 m squared. M into 1 m plus 6 into m, 6 m plus 6 into 1, 6. Right? Then further simplify. M plus 1 into bracket. 2 m squared plus 1 m plus 6 m. Okay? 7 m. Plus 6 divided by 6. That equals, again simplify, m plus 1 into bracket. Observe it. In the numerator, it is quadratic. It has two rows. Splitting numerator, factorize, upper PC. 2 into 6, 12. If you multiply by any two number, you get 12. Add that same number, you get 7. Now, you multiply by another 12 per way. Add minus 7 per way. What are the numbers? 4 3s are 4 3s are 12. 4 plus 3, 7. So we write 2m square plus 4m plus 3m plus 6 divided by 6. 2m square plus 4m plus 3m plus 6 divided by 6. Then further simplify m plus 1 into bracket from first to term. What is common? 2m common into bracket remaining term m plus 2, right? Plus among these two, what is common? Here the common is 3 common m plus 2 divided by 6, right? Then again reduce it, m plus 1 into bracket first factor m plus 2, right? Second factor is 2m plus 3 divided by 6. Okay, that is equal to m plus 1 into bracket m plus 2 as it is into 2m plus 3. 2m plus 3 can be written as 2 plus 1 because 2 plus 1 is 3, right? Divided by 6. 2m plus 3, 3 can be written as plus 2 plus 1. Okay. Then further simplify, that is equal to m plus 1 into bracket. In first term, m plus 2. M plus 2 can also be written as, we can write like this, m plus 1 plus 1. Very well, because 1 plus 1 is 2. In second factor, 2m plus 2 plus 1. Leave it last number, 2m plus 2. Among those two, you get better again common is 2 common is a time. So take 2 common into bracket m plus 1. 2m plus 2 into 1 plus 2. Last number has this 1 divided by 6. Check it. Very nice. The value of m plus 1 is m plus 1 value. M plus 1 value. N. Again, m plus 1 value is n plus 1. Right? 2. M plus 1 value is n plus 1 divided by 6. Is there? Yes. The answer will be the reduced part of it. That is the result. Okay. Clear. M plus 1 value n. Again, m plus 1 value n plus 1. 2 into m plus 1 value n plus 1 divided by 6. Is there? Yes. Therefore, the result is true for n is equal to m plus 1. Hence my mathematical induction. Hence my MI. The result is true for all values of n. All values of n, it means all three steps, namely step number 1, n is equal to 1, step number 2, n is equal to m, step number 3, n is equal to m plus 1. In all cases, the given data holds good. This is the result for mathematical induction. Conclusion was, the conclusion was marked with the, okay, the conclusion for a new, hence my mathematical induction, the result is true for all values of n. Okay, I will repeat once again. Problem number 2, prove by mathematical induction that 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on plus n square is equal to n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6. This is general result. Each general result prove by correct, we must apply mathematical induction. To prove by mathematical induction, it consists of 3 steps. Step number 1, for n is equal to 1. Take LHS, in LHS of last term, n squared, by taking n value 1, put n is 1, 1 squared, that is 1. Take RHS, this is RHS, put n equal to 1, 1 into 1 plus 1, into 2 into n value 1, plus 1 divided by 6, that is 1 plus 1, 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 plus 1, 3, divided by 6, 2 into 3, 6, divided by 6, 6, 6 cancel, that is 1, LHS 1, RHS is also 1, so LHS is equal to RHS, the result is 2 for n is equal to 1. Step 1 to 1, 1 mark. Step number 2, just to replace n by m, n is the m substitute point, n is equal to m, then replace n by m in given data, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on, plus m square, n will be m, m square is equal to m into m plus 1 into 2 m plus 1 divided by 6. Step 2 is also 2. Step 1, step 2, no problem. Step number 3, for n is equal to m plus 1. Adding m plus 1 term, namely adding this step number 2. Look here, in LHS of last term, LHS part of the last term, meaning the end of the last term, and n is the n substitute part of the m plus 1 substitute. No, n is the n plus 1 and the m plus 1 whole power. That amount add on both sides. So adding m plus 1 term, namely adding m plus 1 whole power 2 on both sides in step number 2. That is the method in step number 2. Step 2 in A, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on plus n square. Write as it is. Adding plus m plus 1 whole power 2 is equal to right side value as it is. M of m plus 1 equal to m plus 1 by 6. Adding m plus 1 whole power 2. You look at it for it is balanced. One side add for it, it is imbalanced. Okay, adding m plus 1 goes to the common factor. Let's simplify right hand side. Among those two, what is common factor? M plus 1 common factor. Take m plus 1 outside, remaining value m of 2m plus 1 divided by 6 plus 1 factor m plus 1. Right? Now among those two, LCM of 6 and 1 is 6. 6 1s are 1 6 m into 2m, 2m squared, m into 1m plus 6 into m, 6m plus 6 into 1, 6. Further simplify, m plus 1 equal to 2 m square, 1 m plus 6 m, 7 m plus 6 divided by 6. That is m plus 1 equal to 2 m square. Now in the numerator it is 40. It has 2 roots, splitting up in the 6 roots are 12. If you multiply by any number, you get 12. Add that same number, you get 7. Those numbers are 4 and 3. 4 3s are 12. 4 plus 3, 7. So 2 m square plus 4 m plus 3 m plus 6 divided by 6. Therefore, in first two terms, what is common? 2m common, remaining value m plus 2. Among those two, what is common? 3 common, m plus 2. Right? Divided by 6. That is m plus 1 into 8. First factor m plus 2, second factor 2 m plus 2. You know how to factorize. So, that plus 1 comes to divide it. That's standard. M plus 2 into 2m plus 3 divided by 6. That is m plus 1 into 8. M plus 2, 2m plus 3 can be written as 2 plus 1. Yeah, if I put the answer is equal to 2n plus 1 beta. That's why 3 can be written as 2 plus 1. Don't write 1 plus 2. Of course, 1 plus 2 is 3. But in answer, last term is 1. So that we can write 3 can be written as 2 plus 1. Right? now that is m plus 1 into bracket. M plus 2 can be written as m plus 1 plus 1 into 2m plus 2. From those two, we get a quotient. We get a common area, 2 common area. 2 common area, m plus 1 plus 1 divided by 6. Check if the value of m plus 1 is, m plus 1 will be included in n. This is n, this is also n plus 1 into 2, this is n plus 1. Okay, n into n plus 1 into 2 n plus 1 divided by 6. Is there? Yes. Therefore, the result is 2 for n is equal to m plus 1. Hence, by mi, the result is 2 for all values of m. That is the second problem. 5-1 question. Most important problem expected. That question was asked several times. No re-hearing problem. So, here I am not going to go. 2-3 times we have to observe video. Isn't it? Okay. So, remaining problems we will discuss in next class. Okay, students? Thank you.